In this video, I'll show you how to construct the PUMA Z stage. The stage is at the heart of all PUMA microscopes, from the simplest foundation scope to the most complex research scope. I'm not going to describe the various add-ons and upgrades, such as fitting a slide holder or a Z motor. Such things will be the subject of separate tutorials. Today, we're only going to build the bare stage with its manual focus gears. These are the parts and some of the tools you'll need to build the PUMA Z stage. Details are provided in the video description. All these components are either 3D printed or widely commercially available. The Z stage mechanism consists in a focus plate on top, to which the above stage optics are fixed via this quick release mechanism. And a base plate below, where the specimen is placed. These are connected to each other by three focus posts, which are 70mm long M6 bolts, the threads of which form the basis for the Z motion via a geared pulley and timing belt mechanism. The focus posts and the holes they pass through are named front, XY, and course. The XY focus post is so named because this is closest to the stage XY controls when a mechanical slide holder is fitted. The course focus post is so named because this post has the course focus gear fitted to it. These elevated parts of the base plate around the focus post holes are called risers. For the 3D printed components in general, prior to construction, you must first remove any structures that are not part of the functional model itself, such as bed adhesion pads or supports, and any stray plastic strings, etc. First, we assemble the adjustable articulations. Insert a PTFE ferrule from the top surface of the articulation and press it into the hole until it is stopped by the lower rim of the hole. This should result in a 1mm protrusion of the PTFE ferrule from the top surface of the articulation. This will act as a spring stay to prevent the springs from catching on the focus post threads, as we'll see later on. Now, assemble the eccentric belt tensioners. First, sand the inner aspect of the timing belt with fine sandpaper in a circumferential direction. Clear away all traces of sandpaper grit when done. Next, insert the M4 nut into its recess using an M4 screw and washer to pull it all the way in. grease the inner aspect of the timing belt, and assemble the parts. Test by hand to ensure rotation is smooth. Next, we prepare the pulleys and focus gears. Ensure the central holes in the pulleys and focus gears are clear of any imperfections that would hamper rotation. You can do this by passing a bolt thread in and out, using the thread itself as a kind of gentle file, until the component spins freely on the M6 bolt, but is not so loose as to wobble along the axis. Don't use an actual file, because that risks opening the central hole too much, and in an uneven way, which could allow excessive play and unstable focus action. All pulleys have a partial M6 nut recess on top. Place an M6 nut in each recess, taking care to place any stamped face of the nut downwards, leaving only the smooth surface of the nut showing. Now prepare the focus plate. Insert an M4 nut into the front recess. Then insert the adjustable articulations so that the tops of the articulations are level with the top surface of the focus plate. This will be with the slots in the tops of the articulations all aligned in the front to back direction. Finally, make a few passes with the quick release trainer to ensure the quick release receptacle is clear of any 3D printing imperfections. Take care not to cross the thread when doing this, or you could break these fine bridges. Now prepare the base plate. Insert all nuts into their countersunk pockets, with the flat, unstamped surface of any nut facing the bottom, so any stamped marks face upwards. This is to keep flat surfaces against flat surfaces. Note that this is opposite to how we inserted the nuts in the pulleys previously. For the M4 nuts at the front, you can fit these by simply screwing an M4 screw up from the bottom and tightening it. Ensure a penny washer is used to avoid damage to the undersurface of the base plate while doing this. For the M6 nuts, you must first insert them partially into their recesses from the top. This can be done by placing them on a bolt and using the bolt as a handle to push them in. This is especially useful for the front and XY focus post holes that have only partial risers over the recesses. For the three focus gear risers, coarse, intermediate, and fine, you can simply place the nut over the recess and squeeze them in till flush with the surface by inverting the plate and pushing down against a hard surface. You should use a protective layer, like some scrap wood, so as not to damage your bench or tabletop surface while doing this. Once partially inserted, use an M6 bolt to screw up from the base aspect until they are fully inserted. Use a penny washer not to damage the bottom surface of the base plate. Be careful never to over-tighten nuts against the bottom of the base plate, even with penny washers in place, so as not to deform or stress or, even worse, crack the base plate. Such damage and distortion would be detrimental to alignment of the base plate with the focus plate. All the preceding work can generate small fragments of metal coming off from the screw or bolt as it rubs against the washer or screwdriver, so ensure all tiny metal fragments are cleaned away before proceeding. Placing a fiber washer between the nut or screw head and the penny washer can minimize this. Now insert the front and XY focus post bolts through the base plate from underneath. Use a normal M6 washer for the front and a penny washer for the XY post. I orientate the washer so the sharp surface of the washer contacts the plastic and the smooth surface facing the head of the bolt. Only make the bolts finger tight at this stage. You want there to be a little play until we fit the focus plate. Put the focus spacers around the front and XY posts and thread their pulleys over those posts all the way down to hold the spacers in place against the risers. Put the 300mm GT2 timing belt around the front and XY post pulleys and insert the coarse focus gear pulley into the belt. Now, manually hold this pulley against the opening of the coarse focus riser while inserting the coarse gear focus post from the underside of the base plate with a penny washer in situ until it threads through the coarse gear pulley nut. Then continue to screw it all the way up till finger tight. Grease the focus post threads and articular nut surfaces and the cup washers. Place the cup washers over the focus posts, like so. We are now ready to fit the focus plate. Insert the focus plate over the focus posts, taking care to keep it level as much as possible all the way down. Tilting it will make it hard to move because there is very little play. Now that the focus plate is in position, you can tighten the focus post bolts against the bottom of the base plate with a 10mm spanner, but not so tight as to deform or crack the plastic. Remove the focus post spacers. Add the focus springs, ensuring that the base of each spring goes around the protruding part of the PTFE ferrule. Then add an M6 washer and a nylock nut to the top of each focus post. Make them finger tight, then tighten each by a further 180 degrees with a 10mm spanner. Rotate the coarse focus gear to move the focus plate all the way up till the springs are fully compressed. Don't go any higher or the spring coils will fold over each other. Take the intermediate focus gear, hold it upside down, and pass its 50mm bolt through the top until the threaded end of the bolt just protrudes through the bottom. Put an M6 washer on the end of that bolt with the smooth surface of the washer facing the gear. Hold this assembly upside down, invert the stage, and place the gear in position. Then push the bolt through further into the intermediate gear riser hole till it engages its M6 nut. You can now put everything the right way up and screw the bolt in by hand, but not all the way, not even finger tight, and don't put the undersurface nut on at this stage. You want to allow some play in this intermediate gear position till we fix the fine gear in place. Insert the fine focus fixing bolt through the fine focus gear and place an M6 washer over the whole of the fine gear riser with the smooth surface of the washer facing up to the plastic of the gear. Place the bolt into its hole and tighten till finger tight. Now rotate the fine gear to lower the focus plate. Ensure rotations are smooth with even pressure required throughout several full rotations. Only then return to the intermediate gear bolt, tighten it finger tight only from on top, then add an M6 washer and nut to the bottom aspect and tighten these. As always, avoid over-tightening so as not to damage or distort the plastic of the base plate. Insert the M6 washer and nut over the fine focus gear bolt as it protrudes from the base plate and similarly tighten it. Now attach the front two leg stump bolts. These are 16mm long M6 hex bolts. Use a washer and nut from the underside of the base plate with the sharp surface of the washer facing the undersurface of the base plate. Ensure the bolt head hexagon is in line with the cavity on the base plate and tighten to sink the bolt head into the cavity. Once resistance is felt, tighten by another quarter turn, no more. At this stage, you can attach the belt tensioners to the focus plate. You should attach them with the minimum tension setting to begin with. They can be adjusted once you're looking down the completed scope with a high power objective. there will be an optimum amount of tension that minimizes XY hysteresis in the focus action. Too much tension can make this worse, so it's always best to start at the minimum setting. The basic stage assembly is now complete, but you must check that it is level before using it in a complete microscope. The leveling procedure will be described in detail in a separate tutorial. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and hit the big red subscribe button to get news of related videos as they become available. Remember, if you don't want to do all this 3D printing and assembly work yourself, Then fully assembled and tested PUMA microscopes and parts are available from our online store at www.optark.co.uk. Purchasing from this store supports the channel and the PUMA project as a whole. Thanks for watching.